Thrombophlebitis, it's inflammation of the vein that is accompanied by formation of a thrombus. But sometimes, after inflammation of the one group of veins, for example veins of the lower limbs, patient's condition improves and the inflammation resolves. But then inflammation reoccurs and now it affects another group of veins, let's say the veins of the abdominal wall. And this condition called migratory thrombophlebitis, also called Trousseau syndrome. This condition most commonly occurs in patients with adenocarcinomas of the stomach, pancreas and lung. And the reason is that adenocarcinomas is a tumor that is able to secrete into the blood various biologically active substances. One of them are mucins. Mucins are highly glycosylated glycoproteins that are typically secreted by epithelial cells into the lumen of the gastrointestinal tract. For example, gastric epithelial cells secrete them into the gastric lumen. But cancer cells produce aberrantly glycosylated mucins, and they secrete them not into the lumen, but into the blood. And once these mucins enter into the circulation, most of them are uptaken by the liver, but some portion of them are resistant to liver clearance, so-called resistant mucins. And resistant mucins in the blood bind and basically activate P-selectin adhesion molecules on platelets. P-selectin is a key adhesion molecule that in activated state binds to P-selectin glycoprotein ligand type 1 on leukocytes with formation of a platelet leukocyte aggregates in the small blood vessel. And once leukocytes bind to platelets, they become activated and begin to produce pro-inflammatory cytokines that promote inflammation in the affected vessel. And also P-selectin binds to sulfatides on platelet surface. And by P-selectin molecules, platelets interact with each other and this provokes platelet aggregation, which is a major event in thrombiformation. So in both cases, P-selectin is working like a glue that provides interactions between platelets and leukocytes, and also it provides platelet aggregation that results in formation of a platelet leukocyte aggregates inside blood vessel. Another substance that is released by cancer cells is tissue factor. Cancer cells have an abnormally high amount of tissue factor in their membranes. They can release tissue factor into the blood in form of tissue factor positive microparticles. These particles have very high procoagulant capacity because they activate factor 7 that subsequently induce activation of factor 9 that cause activation of factor 10, thereby tissue factor activate entire extrinsic coagulation pathway. Another substance released by cancer cells called cancer procoagulant. In fact, it's cysteine proteinase that can cleave a part of factor 10 protein, thereby directly activating it. So tissue factor and cancer procoagulant both leads to activation of factor 10, and eventually factor 10 converts prothrombin into thrombin, and thrombin converts fibrinogen into fibrin that stabilizes platelet aggregates, and this results in formation of a formidable thrombus. So overall, we see that the production of mucins induce events of primary hemostasis, and in this case, platelet leukocyte aggregates are analogy to platelet plaque, and tissue factor together with cancer procoagulant induce events of the secondary hemostasis that stabilize platelet leukocyte aggregates, and this results in formation of a thrombus inside blood vessel. The treatment of choice is heparin itself and low molecular weight heparins as enoxaparin, dalteparin, and fondaparinux. Heparin is a perfect choice because first of all, it blocks binding capacity of P-selectin adhesion molecules, thereby preventing formation of platelet leukocyte aggregates, and also heparin directly inactivates factor 10, thereby disrupting stabilization of platelet leukocyte aggregates, and this prevents thrombus formation. So heparin blocks two crucial steps that lead to formation of a thrombus. In terms of clinical findings, patients with thrombophlebitis migraines present with pain, erythema, and with induration along the course of the affected superficial vein. And by induration, we understand that the vein is hard and tender with palpation. Obviously, these three clinical signs are caused by inflammation. Also, during palpation, we can find palpable nodular coat, which is the thrombus within the affected vein. And also, we can find brownish discoloration along the previously affected veins. And this discoloration is caused by hemosiderin deposition in the previously affected site.